The turning of the back and the tongue being out is like a part of the starter kit of a mastering of the twerkish. Yeah, for sure.
Before when I do it again.
This is boy Rare back, and what's Rare channel back at again? Amateur is up the hook bang. Know what time it is, man. It's your boy Rare back again, about to jump into a new reaction. Today, we jumping into some Megan Thee Stallion featuring Dua Lipa, The Sweetest Pie or Sweetest Pie. Man, honestly, I have no real expectations on what to expect from this record. I do think it's an interesting pairing of collaborating artists. They both are some of the biggest of this generation, this era of music we're in. I don't even, the TV on, this is crazy. I mean, it's been on the whole time. You know? Just ridiculous. I mean, I guess I'm probably talking so loud you can't even hear that shit. Yeah, man, anyways. Yeah, man, Dua Lipa, to me, she's like the current Katy Perry of this era. Katy Perry is still well around and releasing music, but she's the fresher face in the pop world. Megan Thee Stallion being one of the premier female artists on the rap hip hop side. And yeah, you know, in theory, it seemed like it'll make a great smash, a record that'll probably eat up the charts. I'm not sure who exactly record it is, if it's Megan's or Dua's.
I was just fantastic.
But we shall see, man. My guess is it's going to be a pop record. You know, it's kind of almost inevitable to be that when you got somebody such as Dua Lipa. But let's just get into it, man.
It's beautiful.
Man, you know that's 3D or, I mean, CGI or green screen. It is beautiful, I will say that.
Look at this body.
Look at the trees' bodies. Yeah, let's give that a little attention now. What do you think about that? Are you feeling these bodies?
I am. You know, I love the woman's body.
Oh, I think it's one over here that I missed.
Oh, did you see them down there?
Yeah, I seen them.
I didn't see
them. Now, look at this over here, though, baby. This is Megan Thee Stallion in tree form.
I thought this one was.
Yeah, this one probably is the symmetrical version of that one for sure. They look just the same. I feel that, man. Ain't messing my joints up, you hear me? Bro, I promise you, I think that's that dude from Big Energy, and that was in that Sweetie video, too. Remember the dude that was like, he in all these videos?
Fine.
I believe that's him, dog. This dude got the number one video man job in America.
He's beautiful.
I ain't gonna lie, he pretty icy. Was that a vagina? I mean, this is just, I mean, look at her. Megan Thee Stallion look like she is a character off of Mortal Kombat or something, baby. Hold on. Let me see if this is a vagina right here that's supposed to be. It looks like it from the visual we have her, but the way it opens up is what really gave it to me. Look at them legs. They got to be. You see them legs up there, right?
Yeah, but what is?
I don't know. It's something. I tell you that. It's something in the future. This is future pussy.
That beeping, that Kanye West thing.
Word. I don't know. Is it beeping? Nah, that shit ain't on. Let's just get into it, though. Man. Vagina got teeth in it. What the hell is that?
You ever seen a movie Teeth?
Yeah. Shit crazy. I have. Dude, it ain't even been a minute, dog, and I just stopped it about four times.
What? I'm just thinking about how black girls, like when we twerk, we stick our tongue out. Do you think white girls do that?
I don't know. First of all, it's very, I don't know if I want to say that, but for all, let me try to see. When white girls are twerking, it's a little distinctively different than how a black girl's twerks. Hmm. So I'm imagining when you ask that question of them, and it's a little bit different, I must say. And I don't necessarily see the tongue coming out as much as urban women tend to do.
I mean, because it's just like,
It's just like, what does that mean?
It's almost like it's a part of...
Part of the twerking. Yeah. It's the tongue out with the looking back is definitely... I don't know what that is. It has to be something. I'm not sure, though. But the turning of the back and the tongue being out is like a part of the starter kit of a mastering of the twerkage. Yeah, for sure. Let me go back to... I ain't going to go back that far. Let's go right here. I just got to see how she drops down. These outfits are already a pretty a lot going on.
You don't like them.
I don't know. What? Look at hers. Look how she comes down. All right. Do a leap of matching that energy, Megan. What we doing? All right. I ain't mad at that. Now, did you see them trees or whatever's back there?
I didn't.
Baby, they are clapping that ass. Look at this. Look at her face, baby. Woo, she's serious. Check out these corners right here. Hey, man, whoever did the editing on that, dog, they killed that shit. That look like some real ass. Well, that little skirt on her ass gonna flop off of her. Man, look at her skin, baby. That shit look like gold. I ain't gonna cap.
It does. With that outfit.
All right. Dua Lipa playing the demon in this mug. You hear me?
Did you see that shadow?
Yeah, that shit was crazy. They got Megan looking like money in here. I ain't gonna cap. Ooh, that shit kind of crazy. Ooh, man, it's a lot going on in this video, dog. A pie slices out of her face. Across the room. All right, Lua.
That tone on her voice is nice.
Oh, it is. Hey. Okay, I'm enjoying this.
I am too.
The animation on this mug is ridiculous. Ooh, baby. You're like, you're like, the sweetest pie. Me and Dua Lipa get the party lit. What the hell's happening right here? What that nigga with the claws?
Edward Scissorhands.
Yeah. That shit, I always thought he was a dope outfit for Halloween. There you have it, man. Dua Lipa, Megan Thee Stallion. Sweetest pie. Let me say this off rip. Any mouth products, whatever you got, whatever company out there that's pushing mouth products, I mean, you're doing yourself a disservice if you're not giving a partnership deal to somebody like Megan Thee Stallion. I mean, you got to. You know what I'm saying?
Mouth products.
Mouth products, man. Mouthwash. Hey, because I'm just being 100, man. The mouth is very marketable. Yeah. With the tongue itch that's going right on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, if I'm a CEO of a mouth product company, I'm looking at that. What's your media takeaway? That's my media thoughts for sure. Now, that video has a lot to talk about, though. What do you think?
I don't know. I lost my thoughts thinking about these mouth products.
Mouth products, man. Mouthwash, toothpaste, gum, whatever, spearmint, freshman gum, anything. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, what you thinking, though? How did you like the song?
Oh, my God. I actually really liked it.
Really?
Yes, I did. Even though she was still on there talking about the same stuff, it wasn't so hard. And maybe it's because the music wasn't so hard.
For sure.
But it was nice.
Yeah, no, nah, man. Enjoyed it. So, just observing the music first and foremost. Yeah, the song, like you said, still talking about the same substance, which it can be a little redundant when it comes to Megan Thee Stallion. But because of the music left such a big impression, like production wise, sonically, even execution wise, yeah. It was softer, more top 40 pop-ish. Like I said, it's inevitable to not go that way when you have somebody like Dua Lipa on there. As far as Dua Lipa, man, I must say, after hearing her on this record and the tone that she kind of channeled on her, I'm interested to see her go down a more urban R&B lane. Oh, I would very much like to just see what that can possibly be, if anything.
Even before all of like the music came in, like at the beginning, when it was, I don't know the instruments, you would have to tell me, but it wasn't much going on and she just had like some vocals. My immediate thought was, I don't know, maybe this will be R&B and not pop.
Well, they definitely both, it's a fusion of pop, R&B, and of course hip-hop. You know, of course with the drums and stuff in there, and then just the bright sounds in there, and I think just probably I would have to go and re-listen to some of the stuff that was going on, but it was just more melodic things going on in there that was R&B geared as well. But yeah, man, so as far as the music, I'm definitely pleased with the music. The video was even the more, like, if you wasn't impressed by the music, the video even kind of almost topped that, you know what I mean? The video kind of almost topped the music, because visually, dog, it was a lot going on with just what was going on in the background. I'm thinking about the scenes where they had like the trees, like that was looking like bodies and they was throwing their ass. What Megan Thee Stallion was doing, she had a lot going on. She did look pretty awesome in here. Like, I think the I was having a problem with the earlier.
I was just gonna say, I didn't like that one where she had like the president's wig. Right.
But I was definitely a fan of the one where she was like in
that gold. That
gold, it was a scene in there where she was like sitting, like it had like multiple images of her from the back
on the thing.
Yeah, man. So, and Dua Lipa, she didn't like, I don't know if somewhat she may have almost stole the show, but it didn't like take away from what Megan was doing as well. I think they really met each other in the middle ground and like accompanied that.
She was like turning into the spider in there.
Yeah, that shit was crazy. Like, her eyes was popping out like bubble gum. I mean, shit was crazy. Middle fingers was coming out of her eyes. I mean, this shit was over the top, bro. Like, and typically, bro, like K-pop videos kind of almost be over the top for me a lot of times. But this one was just like at the threshold of where it's like, they hit the mark and just stopped right when they got there. Of being like almost overtly too much, doing stuff visually and just all the animation.
Oh yeah, they were perfect. They did not go too far.
Yeah, they was right there where it was like, this is my tolerant level. You know what I mean? And like I said, I had no expectations. And typically, if I have no expectations about a record, I go into it and it supersedes the common expectation. With me having none, I kind of have this response. You know what I mean? Because I'm not fans of neither. I respect what they do from afar, and I'm aware of what they do, but I was just going into it just trying to see what was going on because I thought the collaboration was pretty interesting. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, knew it was a lot to say on this one immediately after I saw it. So, get in the comments. Let me know what y'all think. Leave 5 emojis, daughters 5 not. Let me know what it really is. Make sure you hit the like button. Hit that subscribe button if you already haven't subscribed to the channel. Turn on notifications so you don't miss the next video. Shout out to Rare Gang and everybody that's already been supporting and subscribing. Know what time it is, man. It's your boy Rare and Victoria. Thanks for watching. We out here. Yeah. Did it before and I do it again.